Welcome back, DIYers. Today's project's tackling this front door. Now, question for you. Does your front door look a little weathered and beaten up like mine does? Needing a fresh coat of paint? Whether it's wood or metal, have some dents in it that need to be fixed? Or in my case, down at the bottom there, I got some rust I gotta try and fix? Or you're in luck, so does mine. So just so you know, this is the first time I'm tackling a project like this. So you know there's gonna be some hiccups and bumps along the way, and stick around to the end of the video. I'll go over those and show you how we can avoid them next time. So if you need to do this to your front door, you won't have those hiccups and bumps in the road. So with that, let's go get started. So the first thing in this project, we gotta get the door off the hinges. So let's go inside and I'm gonna show you how we're gonna do that. Okay, we're on the inside here and I need to remove these pins out of the hinges. And I'm just gonna take a nail punch and a hammer and do so. But basically you're gonna take this in here, hammer it till the pin comes out. Now, that's easy. Problem is down here on this one, can't do that. It's mushroomed on both sides, so this pin doesn't come out. I don't know if that's a safety feature for breaking into a house or what it's for. Somebody happens to know, leave me a comment and tell me. So basically we're gonna have to remove this hinge to get it off. All right, so I moved the paint stuff out of the heads of these Phillips screwdrivers. Basically, I'm just gonna take my little power screwdriver here, remove these screws. One thing you notice is they're all the same length. Thought they were supposed to put one in or two in, it was longer, so it went through the jam and everything for protection-wise, but I guess not. Just like that, this hinge comes out. Now, this isn't a spring-loaded hinge. Some of you may actually have a spring-loaded hinge, but this particular one isn't. Just so I don't lose them, I'm gonna put the screws back in. Okay, that's done. Now we'll go inside, remove the hinge pins, and take the door off. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna take the bottom pin out first. And I took the bottom pin out first, and because I want the door supported by this top hinge, because remember we took the center one out, and when I take this out, it falls at the top, and that bottom one's out and it doesn't pinch it. Whether it's right or wrong, I don't know, but that's how I'm doing it. And I'm taking care not to screw up the interior trim when I do it. Okay, I'm ready to take the door off here. Now I'm leaving the hardware on for now, but when I go to paint, I'll take that off. But I did pull out this peephole because I got some stuff I need to do around it. Now I don't know how heavy this door is. It's a metal skin. It's got wood around the edges, but the center is all styrofoam. Guess that's their version of a solid core door. It's not too bad. I put cardboard on my sawhorses so I don't scratch up my interior finish. Like that, we're ready to get started. Not yet. One other thing I gotta take care of, I gotta close this off so I don't get a bunch of bugs in. And two, so my dogs don't come out. And three, so the wildcats in their neighborhood don't come in. I'm just gonna use my masker here with plastic. It's 9-foot plastic. Just gonna put it over the doorway area here. And just like that, I got the door sealed off. So let's get to work on the door. All right, first thing I'm gonna do is go around and feel. This door gets really hot out here in this sun. There's a dent, a dent, a dent. And I'm just gonna go around and mark all the dents so I don't miss any. Now the other thing is I got some rust along here I need to fix. And this door sweep or whatever, it's kind of in bad shape. I'm gonna take it out. Now, I don't know if all of them are like that, but this here almost feels like it's got a metal base because it bends up and stays. But basically, down in here are a couple of grooves, and I'm gonna take this screwdriver and just pry this out real gentle-like. You see how it's got a wooden bottom and a wooden side, but it's basically just a metal overlay core. You can see how this is coming out, it's staying bent. It's got to have some metal in it. But we'll finish taking this out and then we can expose all that rust. So you can see we've exposed this rust and I'm really, 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 really hoping it's just superficial. It doesn't go all the way through because if it does, I'm gonna be in deep trouble. But we'll see what happens. So what I'm gonna do is take my orbital sander here, cordless DeWalt. I'll leave a link for it also if you wanna look at it and a video reviewing it. An 80 grit sandpaper, and I'm just gonna go to the areas I've circled and get those down to bare metal and an area around it down to bare metal so we can fix the dents. You can kind of see by just sanding it flat, there's the dent right there. You want to make sure you sand a big enough area around your dent so when we go to fix this with Bondo, you got room to spread, because you don't want to put your Bondo on paint, it won't stick. And you got to leave room for your Bondo to feather out, so you're not going to just fill the hole, but you're going to fill the hole and feather it out to the edges, so you got to have a big enough area to do that. Now, what the sander won't get, I have to do with by hand with sandpaper to get the rest of it out of the dent. Okay, I got these prepped and ready. I'm gonna go through and get all the other ones done, then I'll show you how we're gonna fix these. All right, I got all the spots sanded and cleaned off, and luckily this is all surface rust, and it didn't go all the way through the metal, which is really, really nice, because I don't know how I'd have fixed that, but it's just a tad bit pitted there. I got out what I could. I don't really have any metal etching to put on there, so I'm not sure if I'll just spray primer that and paint or what I'll do, but I've got all the areas sanded down to bare metal. I took and washed the door down, and I took alcohol to it to clean the spots up really good. Now let's get to fixing this. And just how are we gonna fix all these? All-purpose Bondo. Comes with the putty part. This is your hardener. Make sure you knead this really well. Shake it, vibrate it, whatever. Make sure you get this mixed and kneaded really well. Take it from me, that's mistake number one. So here's your first tip. Make sure you knead this really well. A little bit of this goes a long way. Next, scoop you out some putty. It's hard to gauge how much you need. You just scoop some out. Like I say, a little bit goes a long way. Now, time is of the essence. You don't have a lot of time to mess around. Get to mixing this. Take a plastic spreader. Smooth it out. You want to get enough to cover the holes, but not so much it takes you forever to sand. How much is that? Experiment and see. You'll know when it's getting too late, because it'll start to get hard. It won't smooth real good. It'll start to be chunky when it's smoothing. I'm going to overfill this one on purpose. I want to show you a little trick. Now you let it set up. Okay, it's been about 5 minutes, and I overfilled this on purpose. And the reason is if you do that, take your scalpel blade and just run it over it and shave off the excess. Just like that. Now, depending on how much hardener you put in there, it's going to take anywhere from 15 to 20, 30 minutes to dry, and what the outside temp is. Directions say it's 77 degrees, it should take 15 to 17 minutes. These have all dried for a good 30. As you can see, I've already sanded a couple of these, and basically what you do is get you a good flat sanding block, 80 grit sandpaper, and you just sand and sand. It'll take a fair amount of sanding too. And don't worry, when you get done sanding, it looks like you've got those spots, you got more Bondo, refill it and do it again. Sand one direction, and sand the opposite direction, 90 degrees. I'll sand on this, when I got it all done, I'll come back and let you see it. All right, so I greatly underestimated how much time it was gonna take to sand this thing. Now you see, I basically took it down to about bare metal everywhere, and I kind of wanted to do that, but I didn't want to do that. I wanted all this paint off of here, and in doing that, it just took it down to bare metal. Now I have this one spot left, and I was just going to kind of show you what I used to get down in here and get these all cleaned out, and that's basically a wire wheel on a drill to get down in these grooves. Now some of you might think, well, this wire wheel's digging in there and gonna make grooves or gouges. And actually it doesn't. If you get the paint off, once you go to sand, I mean, all this is smooth. I did it to all of this and it's really smooth. And I'm also gonna use it to get the paint off this surface and then sand it down. The whole rest of the door is sanded down to 180. I just got this little spot left. I'm gonna get this done, and then we're gonna primer it. So we got the door all prepped, sanded, wiped down, masked off where I don't want paint, and ready for primer. One thing though I wanted to go over with is on this Bondo. When you're sanding this Bondo, to know when you've got it sanded to where you're flat and done is, A, your edges will all be feathered. If you look at that, they're all feathered edges. There's no sharp corners or turns or anything. And two, when you rub your hand over it, from the door to the Bondo is a smooth transition. There's no hump. But if you've got any kind of straight hard lines, you've got to keep sanding because it's not feathered out to the edge. So just remember that. It takes a lot of sanding on some of this, depending if you get it too thick. So I'm gonna wipe the door down one more time, get my paint ready, and we'll be back in primer. Okay, we're all set. I'm gonna use my HVLP sprayer because I only need a small amount. It's not enough worth getting my big airless sprayer out. And the other thing is I'm gonna paint two coats lightly of this primer. I'm gonna paint this direction and this direction, and that'll be one, so I get good even coverage with all these different profiles. Let that set for about 10 minutes. Then I'm gonna come back and spray it again. I want a good heavy coat, if you will, of primer on there, because I'm gonna come back when it's all dry and take 400 to it and smooth it out. First thing I need to do is get my spray pattern set. And the other thing is I'm gonna do the edges first, because when you do the edges, it sprays up on top of here. And so then I'm gonna come back and do the top. That way there's no overspray roughness on the top if I do the edges last. But you can see it's not completely covered, and that's okay. I'm gonna give this about 10 minutes, come back and do it again. If I have to, I'll do three coats. But I don't want one heavy coat and cause a bunch of runs that I have to fix and then reprimer. Okay, I just finished primering and took three coats. Now, you see some black spray paint on there. The reason is I'm gonna sand this when I'm done. And I wanna know how hard, shouldn't say how hard, I wanna know how far to sand before I hit metal. I don't wanna hit metal. So I lightly spray and dust this with black spray paint. When this is dry, I go to sand it. You sand through the black, you're done, just like that. So I'll give this a couple hours or so and I'll come back and we'll sand this. So a couple issues come up since I put the primer on. I had to stop for about 4 days and come back to it. And lo and behold, I've got surface rust that's come all through the primer. Just so you know, primer is porous, and this proves it. As you can see, I got rust that's come through, and for some reason, it's really outlined where I did the previous Bondo work. It's really rusted, but it's rusted everywhere. It's rusted on this hinge. It's rusted down in there where there is no Bondo. So I'm gonna have to go through, unfortunately, sand this all back down to metal, reprimer and paint in one day. Other thing too, is I found when I was primering it, I found three low areas or dents, if you will, and I'm gonna fix those while I'm at it too. Now it's all dried and I've already sanded that half. And basically what I'm doing is I'm sanding until it's either smooth or the black goes away. If the black is gone, you don't wanna go any deeper because the next thing after that's metal. So it's really hard not to do that on the corners. I got a couple corners that I went all the way through. But so I'm sanding right here. I went through the black, it's just white, stop. And after that, I just wipe off the sanding dust, have a feel. Beautiful. I'll finish the rest of this door, get set up, and we'll paint this baby. All right, we're finally ready to paint this door. I'm using, I think it's charcoal blue from Sherwin-Williams. Put my little cap on here so bugs and dirt don't get in there. Actually, before I do that, I gotta get the pump primed. I'm gonna use a fine finish 208 for around the edges. So it's got a narrow spray pattern so I don't waste a bunch. And then for the face of the door,
I'm going with my 415 regular tip. Before I start, test my pressure in the pump and my spray pattern, and then we'll go. So when I paint, I'm gonna start out here and start my hand going, and then pull the trigger and then come into it. And then when I'm done, I'm gonna come past it and let go of the trigger. If I start here, pull the trigger and go, it's gonna be heavy paint and you will get a run. Now, the other reason I'm using a fine finish tip on here is because it's only a 208, so it's only gonna spray a 4-inch pattern, and that's all I need. This is only 2 inches wide. I don't want a big spray pattern because one, it's gonna be a lot of overspray and wasted paint, and two, it's gonna wind up spraying up on top of here, and I don't want that. And then the reason I'm gonna paint the edges first is so, just like I said, when I paint the top, this paint's gonna come up on here. So then when I paint the actual door, I'll come back over that and cover that, and it won't matter. You need to remember to stay about 12 inches away. When I go to paint this, I'm gonna paint this direction, and then I'm gonna come back and paint this direction. And the reason is, it's because of all these folds right here. I only go one direction, I might have some bare spots, and I don't want that. And then I'm gonna try and keep it flat. The other thing is I got some M1 extender in this paint, which will help it settle out and be glass smooth when it's all said and done. And you see there, my overlap's about 50%. So I'll go back the other way, and I can already see I missed right there. That's okay, because I'll come back this way and take care of that. All right, all covered. So we'll let this dry. We'll come back and see how glass smooth it is. It's about 2 hours have gone by since I finished painting it. And from a distance, it looks really good. Now this finish on here is a satin, so it's not gonna have a high glossy finish. Now I know you're seeing those over here. Those are ripples, those aren't dents. Now there are a couple of dents I missed, but in the grand scheme of things, this thing came out great. Here's a close up of the finish. It's smooth as butter. All those white specks you see, that's debris that's on top of the paint after it dried. When I hung the door up, those aren't there anymore. It laid down beautifully. We'll get it hung up in the doorway, have the final reveal. You ready to see the finished project? Here you go. Man, doesn't that look beautiful. If you notice at the first of the video, all those dents we had right here, all gone. Also all the faded paint and rubbed off paint, all gone. Looks really good. Got the new peephole and the new hardware. Man, does this look good. See how smooth that paint laid down? Remember, this is a satin finish, so it's not gonna have that glossy glass finish. Remember the rust we had down here? All gone. Also, put a new door swipe on there. I'll have a link to a video short down below for that. Man, that laid down nice. Now, if you look really close and hunt around, you'll find there's a couple dents that I didn't get. But as a finished project, this looks brand new. And if you know where to look specifically, you can kind of maybe find where the Bondo was. Like I know there's one here you can kind of see. But to the normal person coming up to the door, looks like a brand new door. This is an easy DIY project. On my DIY scale of 1 to 10, because I use two different airless sprayers, I put it as a 4. If you're gonna paint it with a brush, this is easily a 2, and you can do it. Now, a couple of things that I've done different, if I had to do this all over, and that you shouldn't do when you do yours, is A, when I sanded all this down and got all the Bondo sand and got it ready to primer, I wiped it down with alcohol. That was the mistake. The alcohol, I think, soaked into the Bondo. When I went to primer it, came out as a rust look all around the areas where the Bondo was.
And I noticed it when I was laying the primer down that it was doing that, but I was hoping if I put a heavy enough coat, I'd hide it. But obviously I didn't, because the next time I went to primer this, I just wiped it down with a very, very lightly damped rag and then gave it about 10 minutes to dry really well before I laid the primer down, and it worked beautifully. So don't use alcohol, and I didn't use any other products either. And I didn't have a tack cloth. If you have a tack cloth, you could do that. But instead, I just used a very lightly damped rag, and it came out beautifully. One other thing I noticed, and I'd have been just a hair smarter, but you can't see it unless you go looking really hard for it, is I noticed when I was sanding this door, I'd have itty bitty pits, if you will. When I say itty bitty, like maybe the end of a finished nail head type pit, that I'd have to really dig and grind down in there to get all the paint out. Well, those were actually a little bitty dents, and they showed up in the final product. And I say they, there's probably only three or four, but you gotta know where you're looking to find them. But just to stare at this as the video is going, you can't see any of it. I've got one blemish in this paint, and I'm gonna leave it because nobody's gonna really notice it when they come up to the door. It's right there. It's not really a run. It's kind of like some dirt that got swiped through the paint. But as you stand back from here, you can't see it. I have to point it to it. There it is. I really couldn't be happier. The new peephole, new door hardware, freshly painted door, looks like a brand new door. So if you want to see how I put in this new hardware, I'll have a link up here. If you want to see how to put a peephole in your door, there'll be a link up here. It'll also be in the description. So until next time, happy DIYing.